Hello and welcome back. This is Hamburg Mobile Summit Live. And my name is Julia. I'm your host for the first half of the day. We have a very busy schedule, a great agenda prepared by the organizers. And the first session is going to happen right now. We have Tobias Haag, growth leader from TikTok. And we have Tobias here. Hey, Toby, how are you?
Hi, Julia. I'm doing great. How are you?
I'm very good. Happy to be here. Toby, I was going to ask you, so you work at TikTok, right? Are you a TikToker yourself?
I'm a TikToker myself. You can actually, check out my profile. It's TikTok Toby One. And it's quite exciting. I have a couple of videos and played around with the app many times. And I'm personally quite amazed, to be honest.
Okay, I'm going to subscribe while you're talking. How many subscribers do you have, by the way?
I think it's a couple of hundred now. I mean, I have two accounts. I built a mobile game in the past and that has much more. So, but personally, it's growing.
Okay. Well, I was going to brag that I have 16,000 subscribers on TikTok.
That's really impressive.
I know. I mean, it took me a lot of time, to finally download TikTok. But when I did, oh my God, I mean, it's impossible not to use it. It's amazing. And I think that's the best place for advertisers right now, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. I mean, it's definitely very sticky. I had the same experience when I tried it out the first time. And it explains why retention rates are so high.
I know. I mean, it's not for kids, as I used to think. I mean, it's okay for grown-ups as well.
That's definitely true. Absolutely.
All right. Enough of chit chat. We have business to do, and this is your turn to make the presentation, your keynote. Over to you.
Yeah. Awesome. Thanks. And welcome, everyone. As said, my name is Toby. And in this session today, I'm going to talk about how you can boost your performance through creatives on TikTok. Our agenda is comprised of a few different topics. First, I'll share a quick overview on TikTok in general and will explain how TikTok works at its core. Second, we're going to look into 10 secret tips that will make your creatives work and become more successful than ever. After that, we're looking into some case studies that have successfully applied those best practices, and we'll finish off with a Q&A in the end. Before we dive into the content, here a little background about myself. I actually joined TikTok about a year ago, and I'm leading the growth team here in Berlin, where I'm responsible for advertisers in the DACH and Dutch market. Before TikTok, I've actually founded two startups on my own, and did Germany's very first ICO back in 2019, when the crypto hype was on its peak. As an entrepreneur, I was always fascinated by the powers of user acquisition, especially when it comes to building high-performing creatives. That's also why I really love my job, even though I said a year ago that I would never join a corporate. However, here I am, having the pleasure to work with some truly amazing people in my team that help our partners to meet their performance objectives. Some of the faces I guess you might recognize. And as you can see on the right, my team focuses on the business models of our clients to better understand the goals and objectives of our partners. In line with our corporate mission, we also act as ambassadors to inspire creativity and joy. It's the whole foundation of our platform and also the reason why the content we see every day is so diverse and so highly entertaining. Personally, it feels a little bit like stepping into the bright side of the force, which as a father, I'm actually trying to live by every day because positivity really sparks creativity. And that's actually reflected in our numbers. So far, we're currently reaching over 100 million monthly active users in Europe. And globally, this number is even a lot higher. The scale gives advertisers more than enough reach to target the right users around the world. And since our users are spending a lot of time on the app and are growing with our platform, it's a perfect opportunity for you to take part. What also makes us quite different is that we are the only platform that's built on a content graph rather than a social graph. This means that it doesn't really matter how many followers an account has. Every video has the potential to go viral, It's all about seeing exactly the right content that interests you. That system creates a highly engaged community that likes to spend a lot of time on TikTok, and above all, is curious to discover. That's because we are ultimately an entertainment platform. Somehow, a little bit like the MTV or like MTV in the 90s, with the same cultural impact, but with a democratized approach on discovery. And this also translates to business. For instance, 83% of our users say TikTok played a major role around their purchase behavior at least once, while another 67% said it helped them get ideas about products they've never seen before. The hashtag TikTok made me buy it has now well over 3 billion views and has become a product discovery feature on its own. Commercially speaking, that's because TikTok inspires purchases. And exactly that inspiration turns into action, with almost a quarter of our users saying that they bought something they saw on TikTok. And as everyone knows, the more seamless the flow, the better the conversions. You can probably even see this with your own behavior. I personally have tried the hibiscus tiba volvic, and I've also done TikTok pasta, which caused a European short in supply for feta cheese. But what makes it is not only the commercial aspect of things, but how emotional these trends can become. Here an example.
There once was a ship that put to sea. The name of the ship was a Bully of Tea. The winds blew up her bow, up down, oh, below my bully boys blow. Soon may the bullyman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go.
It's so sticky, and I really remember when this was trending back when the lockdown here in Europe was in full motion. Interestingly, the video was actually created by Scottish postman Nathan Evans, who's now responsible for opening up sea shanties to a mass audience and sparking co-creation across the world. But that's just the tip of the iceberg. Every day, thousands of creators are driving new trends on TikTok and support movements that really matter. From Wipe It Down with more than 3 million videos to Bored in the House with 3 billion views, or the Black Lives Matter hashtag, which has now was now used well over 20 billion times. These record numbers are because of our users' creative power that turns moments into movements, far extending our platform by becoming a part of our lives. Like this guy, another Nathan Apodaca, who posted a TikTok of himself cruising the highway on a longboard, drinking Ocean Spray cranberry juice to a Fleetwood Mac song, Dreams, which made headlines across the globe. Currently, his video alone has 81 million views and counting, and the song by Fleetwood Mac became the number one hit on iTunes. The power of co-creation is something you guys here can also use to your advantage, because remember, it all started by sharing just a 50-second moment. And that's why it's safe to call this a new era of creative advertising. The game simply has changed, and the opportunities are now endless. Whether you're using our organic or our paid channels, being creative always wins. And that's especially true for our performance-driven auction campaigns. The most successful ones across the board simply don't look and feel like ads. They feel native. They feel and sound like TikToks. And that's why we are always saying that it simply does not work to use your past display-driven creatives on our platform. It will just feel too much of an ad, like an intruder that's interrupting a highly entertaining journey, or in other words, like an interruption from an old age. To prevent that from happening, here are now our top 10 creative tips that will help you create native experiences to drive your campaign performance. And keep in mind, the most successful advertisers on TikTok are all using more than half of the upcoming tips. First one, tune it up and leverage the power of sound on. TikTok is all about music, and it's your chance to make users feel your experience. Here's an example from India. I obviously don't understand a word, but you get the point. The sound is really catchy and it makes you want to watch the video. Next one in line, flesh out what you have. It's really about getting your key message out early, as it will definitely boost your click-through rates. Here another example. All right, third one, tap into our pool of talents. This can be done through our creator marketplace, which will massively increase your chance to boost your view-through rates and feel very TikTok native. Here an example from a bigger brand, Samsung Galaxy. About to give you awesome life. Awesome screen, awesome camera, long lasting battery life. Awesome screen, awesome camera, long lasting battery life. Come dance with us. Awesome. Yeah, definitely very powerful. Let's move on to the next examples. All right, number four, carve out the edge. This means to capitalize popular trends as a commercial co-creator, like here in this example, where Pizza Hut jumps on a trending choreography. All right, number fifth, try to get a lasting impression. You can do this best by appealing with emotions. Here's a really good example from Goodie Box.
Kostet monatlich 19,95 € und beinhaltet meistens einen Wert von mindestens 70 €. Also, wenn ihr Lust habt, auch auf so eine Box, dann swipet einfach.
You can see how the creator here captures your attention in the beginning by repeating the brand name multiple times. Well, you can really feel afterwards that the creator is truly happy about having received the package. The authenticity really makes it here. Okay, next in line, shoot natively and meet the TikTok culture. Here's an example from the automotive industry. So for all people that live in Berlin, you have a good chance to meet the creator live on the weekends if you're spending time on the Tempelhofer Feld. That's where she usually has a ride. All right, number seven, break the fourth wall and capture the attention of your audience by speaking directly into the camera. It's so much more personal and it feels like you need to stay here and watch this. Here's a very good example from the female company.
Alle Unklarheiten aus dem Weg zu räumen, das ist eine Bio-Binde von der Female Company. Diese benutzt du während deiner Periode und musst du nicht zusätzlich mit einem Tampon oder einer Menstruationstasse kombinieren.
That ad does not only sell, but it also educates, which I think is really, really interesting. Next one in line, master the craft. And here I'm speaking from my own experience. Making a cool TikTok is really easy. And with all the features in the app, you can get amazingly creative. Here's how Maybelline has used a creator combined with native effects on the background and some stickers to make the video feel more native. Maybelline's on that. Again, very catchy, but also quite simple. Next in line, foment the FOMO by driving urgency with a strong call to action. Creating a compelling hook is absolute key. Here an example for that. You see, 30% off right at the beginning Shop now at the end, with both elements having the brightest colors. It's simple, but it works. And now, my final piece of advice. Number 10, cross the barrier and get over the learning curve. Campaign optimization features on TikTok need some time to deliver desired results. And very often, the first set of creatives do not engage. So allow your producers, and often it's just a really small team, I know that from my own experience, to venture broadly into all sorts of creative directions, and only then enter the optimization mindset. The ones that have mastered the game are our rising stars on TikTok. Here are a few examples, of which two, I guess, are today in our audience. First one, Playa Games, who ran a campaign to boost their award-winning title, Shake and Fidget, with an incredible 131% ROAS, while keeping the CPC as low as 6 cents on average. Let's check it out. The ad just feels real and authentic. And this directly translates into a better performance because as a viewer, you simply don't want to be sold. And this guy might even be the founder or the developer of the game. That makes the whole thing really trustworthy. Next in line, Bytrolabs, our friends here from Hamburg, with a campaign to drive high quality installs for Conflicts of Nations. Notice how simple the production is. But again, this feels real, especially with a voice that invites you to join the player's thinking process.
Hey guys, this is part one on hardest countries to play in Conflict of Nations. So in this World War III strategy game, Poland has to be one of the toughest countries to play with. Germany can invade you, Czechia can invade you, Belarus, Ukraine, even Sweden can bring their boats and invade you from the north. Will you play Poland? Which country will you choose? Just download for free and play now.
Bytrolabs here is successfully using a simple form of storytelling. And the best part, the video was shot and delivered in just 24 hours. So testing out new creative directions can be really fast and cost efficient while still performing amazingly well. Last one, here an example from a French gaming studio that is creating multiplayer mobile games which are best enjoyed with friends. Using a group of creators here perfectly underpins the core experience of the game. Check it out.
Moi, j'aurais sauté, hein.
Gauthier, Esther aime bien mélanger les frites avec du milkshake.
Bon, c'est super bon, arrêtez.
Bref, allez jouer sur Vacarme. Gros bisous!
The ad is actually much longer, so for all French-speaking people here in the audience, the scene might be a little bit out of context. All right, we're coming to the end of my presentation, and I only have a few more slides to share. Here are some final pieces of advice. First, use our creative tools to do the work for you. If you only have photos but no videos, use the video template feature. If you have videos and the music, but are lacking some afterward skills, use the smart video and text feature. It's surprisingly powerful. And lastly, if you're lacking the music, use the video soundtrack feature, which will generate custom and license-free background music. And if that's not enough, check out our commercial music library to search for royalty-free songs in all sorts of genres. Doing all of the things right explains why we are able to deliver 14% higher return on ad spend versus other channels. And please don't forget just one thing. Don't make ads, make TikToks. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Tobias. That was great. I love TikTok's presentations because, you know, because you show TikToks. It's always fun, you know, and useful to watch the presentations from TikTok. So let me check if we have questions from our audience.
Sure.
I have one question for you.
Yeah.
As you concluded, don't make ads, make TikToks.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think? Should advertisers from gaming try and create some viral TikToks instead of buying ads? Can that be a strategy, you know, to get all the audience for free? What do you think?
I think you should use both. I mean, I would say the organic channels are perfect for testing out what works. And yeah, as said before, I mean, I've built a hyper-casual game before TikTok and yeah, went through the same route, to be honest. So I built a couple of videos and tested it out. And I think the 30th one started trending, reaching a couple of 100,000 views. So then I knew, okay, that would be something that I could use to scale it up. So I would recommend to use the organic way to test out creative ideas. And of course, if you want to have extra growth or scale up like crazy, use the paid channels to boost that.
Okay, thank you. One more question, personal from me. Is there anywhere where TikTok reveals how videos get to the recommended ones? I mean, is there a mechanism that, you know, you share with someone? I'm wondering.
I think we would never share the exact mechanism. However, you can guess what's happening. So if the first set of viewers are engaged and respond really well, the algorithm will take care of it and spreads out the video to a larger audience. And yeah, it's sort of like a upwards waterfall that will determine the success. So it's really about if you already inspire the first 100 users, you have a good chance to scale up.
Okay. Thank you so much for your presentation. We will be waiting for you on the WN Hub. You can come and chat with the people who watched you. By the way, we have feedback here saying that it was a nice presentation. So it's not just my opinion. Thank you so much for joining us and have a nice day.
Absolutely. You too. Thanks a lot. See ya.
Cool. See ya.